I'll show you the exercises we can do with the model one, the endoscopic manipulation trainer. I have here my first year fellow Tanawat to help me demonstrate. Firstly, before we get into the exercises, we need to make sure that the trainee holds the scope correctly. Particularly for Asians, Asian ladies, the hands are much smaller, so we may need to adjust the hands as I'll show in a second. So normally, if your hand is big enough, you can hold it comfortably so that your middle finger on the left hand reaches over to help support the wheels. If you have a smaller hand, it's not possible to do this, and if you try, it makes it more difficult for you to control the small wheel, so you have to actually use your thumb more. And you do this by rotating your hand a little bit so your thumb is more in control of the large and small wheels. Once you're holding it correctly, we can then go on to use the model one. So I'll show you what the box looks inside. This is the esophagus. And then as you go into the box itself, you see a ring of numbers, a clock face from 1 to 12. You have the red and black spots to train how acutely you want to bend the scope. Also, on retroflexion, there's also another ring of numbers. So you can practice manipulating the endoscope in a retroflex fashion. So now what exercises can you do? We can practice the torquing of the scope. So here, the scope is turned by just twisting the scope for both hands. It might be easier to see with a pointer. So we'll put a needle in. So I suggest you put in the scope about 50 centimeters, and then we can show the movement of the scope with torquing by twisting the left hand and the right hand together. Now, the next exercise is once the fellow, the trainee, is used to moving with torquing, you fix the scope with an assistant's hand with 12 o'clock at the top, okay? And then you force the trainee to just use their left hand to manipulate the large and small wheels. So you can call out the number. So one red, and the trainee is then made to point that spot. And then you can call out on any other number in rows at random. Nine red. Five red. So the red spots are easier to point to. To make it more difficult, you can point to the black spots. Three black. Seven black. Like so. You can also do a whole row of numbers and time your trainee to see how confident or how quick they are at moving the scope with the left hand. Now we can also do this with the retroflex. So if you retroflex, and this is useful for gastric varix injection. But here you allow the trainee to torque the scope. So you can call out a number. Here the red numbers are easier. So five red, okay, and then you go for 11 black, okay, and so on. So that's how you train the endoscope manipulation trainer.